Hi, I am Dr. Vybhav Deraje. I am a consultant craniofacial and plastic surgeon at Aesthetica Veda, Bangalore. Is my child with craniosynostosis going to be fine? Is he or she going to grow up as an absolutely normal individual? This is one of the most concerning questions of all the parents of craniosynostosis children. Now, to answer that, I'll have to divide the craniosynostosis into two different categories, that is, syndromic craniosynostosis and non-syndromic craniosynostosis. In syndromic craniosynostosis, we have seen that around 10 to 15% of the babies can have some mental retardation, can have some developmental delays, and your child might not be absolutely normal when they grow up. Now, that is only with syndromic craniosynostosis like Aperts syndrome, Cruzon syndrome, Saethre-Chotzen syndrome, Carpenter syndromes and things like that. Whereas in non-syndromic craniosynostosis, the story is completely different. Most of the children grow up to be absolutely normal if your child has a non-syndromic craniosynostosis. But there is some data that some children with metopic craniosynostosis can have some speech and learning difficulties when they have craniosynostosis. Now, the data varies and it can range up to from 1% to even 10% of children with metopic craniosynostosis can have these behavioral issues. Some children can have very severe issues, almost going up to an ADHD kind of picture, and some children might have a very minor kind of a learning or a speech delay. It depends upon child to child, and it is difficult to predict for us to see how exactly your child is going to grow up. So we make a note of this and keep your child under monitoring for at least 12 years of age from the time of the surgery in non-syndromic craniosynostosis.